For this lesson, you'll be focusing on practicing DOM manipulation methods. You'll start by accessing data about existing nodes and modifying that data. You'll finish by adding and removing DOM elements. I won't be covering all of jQuery's methods, but most of them follow pretty much the same pattern. And after these examples, you won't have any problem tackling additional methods.
This is the jQuery API documentation. On the left, you can see the main types of jQuery methods. I want to start by modifying the class attribute, so I'll click on Attributes. I can see a few methods. I'll go ahead and start with addClass, which does pretty much exactly what you think it does. It adds a specified class to a DOM element. This black box shows the main function signature, which tells you what to pass in as an argument to this method to get it to work properly. This description is pretty useful. It looks like this method takes in a string of a class name and adds it to selected elements. So if I passed in blue to this method, I'd add the blue class to the element with the ID of item. Inside the black box, you can find different ways of using the method, including this one where you can pass a function to add class. Well, that seems kind of weird. If I read further though, we see that this function must return a string. It could be a string of a single class name, or it could be many class names separated by spaces. And then below, we have some in-depth discussion and some examples. That's pretty cool. In other examples, like .parents for instance, you'll see parameters inside square brackets. The square brackets mean that the parameter is optional and the method will work just fine with or without it. Now that I've walked you through the documentation, I want you to try parsing some documentation for yourself. You're going to start by modifying some data in the DOM.